Hey guys, it's Earnestine here. Welcome back to another video. Obviously you can see I'm tired, but we got things to do, so it's 6:46. My alarm originally rang at 6, but you know how that be. I went back to sleep. This is gonna be an interesting vlog. It is in response to my other sit down video, how to reinvent yourself. Now, if you haven't watched that, I do suggest that you do go watch that, even if you click off this video, because it's really good and it's really needed. It is a Christian girl talk about how to reinvent yourself before the end of the year. Like, don't wait till next month, don't wait till next year, start now. So let's backtrack a little bit. This is before the intro, guys, but anyway, I'm waking up early around 6 a.m. because I noticed that I get more done when I wake up earlier, if I'm being honest. I mean, I set myself a bedtime for 11:30 and wake up between 6 and 7, and it's been working for me for the past couple weeks. But I really just wanted this video to inspire you guys, and if not, uplift you guys and open a new perspective for you. If you want to skip right to the Bible study, go ahead. It is in the timestamps, okay? Good Bible study, by the way. My intentions with reinventing myself is really concerning my relationship with God and myself. You know, I want to start learning how to allow God to change my perspective and simply rely on Him more deeply and to be more in tune with Him. I'm allowing Him to shift my perspective by making more time for Him, changing and transforming certain habits within my life, and simply learning to enjoy myself more often, enjoy spending time with myself, enjoy getting ready, and just not be so on go all the time, but surely be present in where I am. And it's time for a change, and I don't want to wait until the new year to start when I have the power to start now. I just want to remind you that perfection does not exist, so go ahead and get your stuff together now and try your best, because we all out here just trying to live. Okay, so let me give y'all the rundown of what we're gonna do today. So, today I did not do Bible study, by the way, guys. I'm just gonna do Bible study at the park, which I did yesterday. And lately I've been loving going to the park. It's like God literally calls me there and He speaks, and it's so clear. And it's just like I'm out and open. Like, I'm tired of being home all the time. And like, as a content creator, we don't really leave home as much as y'all think we do. I don't know if that's what other people say, but me personally, I don't go nowhere for real. I want to go back to this cafe that I went to yesterday to edit my Shein haul. And if you haven't seen that video yet, be sure to check it out. And they had this matcha carrot cake, and I got it iced, not hot. So iced matcha carrot cake. And I was like, well, carrot cake matcha, my bad, y'all. I ordered it, and I didn't think it was going to be that good. I got a small, and I was like, you know what, let me try something different, because I didn't really want coffee, because coffee was going to mess up my stomach, and I've never had matcha a day in my life. But when I tell y'all, that junk is so good. It's so good. So I had two. I had one before I left there, too, yesterday, so I was like, ugh. But anyway, I think I want to get another one of those today, and then my lash clusters. I gotta take me a shower too, but I want to do my lashes because I don't know, I was supposed to do them earlier in the week, but I was like, I want to do it on camera with you guys because I do want to talk to you guys about like certain things. And we're going to the park, of course, and y'all also gonna get ready with me because I need to pick an outfit. I was supposed to do it last night, never picked the outfit, child.
I feel like you can never have too much jeans, if I'm being honest.
We got three options. Okay, I done showered and everything, guys, but we have three options. This is the first option. Now this, I just feel like this is more like, let me get a better angle. This is more like brunch, like girls day out, This is not, let's go to the park and get a matcha. But at the same time, it's like, it kind of gives, like, let's romanticize our life today. But I don't know, I'm not feeling it. Don't mind. Oh, you can't even see me put my feet ashy, y'all. I got a lotion. I forgot to lotion my feet.
But yeah, this is the first option, right?
Okay, see, the problem with this, y'all see this?
No.
It needs to be like this. So I think I'm gonna cut this in the back,
but this is the second option. I like it, but I don't, but I do at the same time. But anyway, let's move on to the third option. All right, this is the third option. Y'all seen this in the Shein haul. I hope you watched the Shein haul. But this is the third option, you know? It's not backless, like really for real. But it's simple, it's black, and I don't know, what gives park? I feel like the green one gives, let's go to the park. But something about me and black just go together real bad. So yeah, what should I do, y'all?
All right, so boom, we have the green fit back on. Now, I of course, hold on, I'm missing one. I of course want to wear my green bangles. I think I'm going to exclude this one actually. And just wear these three. Yeah. And then I need to pick earrings. I'm sorry, I got an eye booger, which is so crazy because I literally just washed my face.
I think I want to have like a dainty thing going on. I don't know, it's always hot.
So boom. I changed the outfit. I don't know. I was feeling it, but not for today. Y'all know what's stuck in my head? You do the loop de loop and pull, and your shoes are looking good. Now, y'all gotta help me choose some earrings. I don't know. I don't wanna wear any big hoops today. And then there's these. This is the set I'm kinda looking at right now. I don't know, these don't look appealing today. I told myself I was gonna like actually make an effort with like getting ready for the day, even if I feel like I'm not doing anything or like doing anything special. Like I wanna actually get ready for the day and feel cute, feel pretty, and just get myself together. And I don't know if that's for anybody else, maybe that's superficial or whatever. But I don't know, I like to feel and look good. So I'm feeling good today. I wanna look good today, okay? Every time I wash clothes, it's full of night clothes, like no day clothes. Like I don't really go anywhere. So it's like, baby, I need to spice it up. If you can relate, you know what I'm talking about. Like you go to wash your clothes and all you got is work clothes and night clothes. That's it. Like baby, we gotta step it up. So I'm gonna do my lashes, y'all. And the last time I attempted to show y'all how I did my lashes, it turned out horribly. So we're gonna try again, but I'm gonna have you guys at a downward angle because it'd be hard trying to show people what you're doing and you don't even know what you're doing, you know? So I'm gonna do 16, 14, 12, and 10 because like last time I attempted to just like do a countdown, but I think I'm gonna skip a number to see how it looks.
We're using this germery glue right here, if it focuses. Germery glue, Viva Lash. I kinda already put my lashes on there, but this is what it looks like.
I'll have it linked down below in the description for sure. I can't see, so we're gonna be using my mirror.
My mirror is busted, dirty, cracked, but it's still usable, so you can see me? It's still usable, so we're gonna use it, okay?
To the park, and look how pretty it is out here, bro. Don't mind my little busted windshield now, but it's so pretty, right? Something about a park just does it for me, you know. But you guys want to see my lashes? They're a little uneven, if I'm being honest, and I'm looking in the viewfinder. Yes, I am. They're a little uneven, but like they kind of don't match. But we don't know what we got. I wasn't gonna sit here and fix it and take it off and stuff like that. So How y'all like lashes? I feel like they look natural. Are they giving natural?
Yeah. Okay, so let me show you guys this Bible study. It's getting kind of hot out here, so I'm ready to get my matcha. But so he had me in Job chapter 8 and 10. He had me skip 9, which was so weird how he had me chapter hop. Oh. Y'all, it's hot. I'm sorry. And so lately he's been having me in Job. So he's had me like dig into Job's conversations with like the back and forth between him and his friends. I'm going to read you guys what I have. So Bildad, which is the friend, questions his complaints and urges him to turn to God. He's speaking to Job, okay? He encourages him to have faith that better days are ahead, illustrating that God does not punish the innocent and does not deserve to be falsely accused. So Job is weary and he desires that God takes his life. He questions the purpose of this whirlwind. Why had the Lord allowed this? What has he done wrong? Job is essentially confused, guys. So, you renew, chapter 10, verse 17, Amplified Classic Version. You renew your witness against me, your witnesses against me, and increase your indignation and anger toward me. Hardship after hardship is with me, attacking me time after time. So, to Job, the world is against him. He feels undeserving of the treatment and hardships he's been facing. Everything has been snatched away from him, and he has nothing but God. So, Jehovah told me to put it in perspective. So, think of a time when you had nothing and no one to turn to except God. What was your response? Thinking back to a time when I had no job, no money, no outlet, no freedom, no comfort in a season, I felt stripped of everything that gave me confidence, distraction, and freedom. No longer was I able to redirect my focus in my mind to other things because they were gone. So, this is how I am personally. Like, a lot of the time, you know, we use the things around us as distractions. Distractions from what's in our mind. Distractions from what we're feeling. Distractions from what we know what we're supposed to do. Distracting us from spending time with God and hearing God correctly. A lot of the things outside of us are distractions, and that can be a job, that can be finances, that can be a person, that can be a place, that can be an environment mentally, okay, physically, spiritually. Okay, so a lot of the times God allows those things to be taken away from us because he wants to get our attention, and he also wants us to look within him for what we're searching for, what we're seeking for. Because a lot of the times, if you don't learn to establish, if you aren't established in Christ, or even in further seasons in your life, things happen, we deviate, we are not perfect, we're imperfect actually. So it can be hard sometimes for us to actually fully recognize we're distracted, or for us to fully recognize we're not fully submitting to God in this way, or that there's something in our hearts, something in our minds that is holding us back or preventing us from seeing a perspective that God wants us to see through, okay? So, yes. So my reaction, I wallowed in confession and I sought the Lord. So for me at that time, I spoke to the Lord. Me and I felt like me and God were like this at that time. I was crying to him, talking to him, just telling him everything was on my mind, even complaining, y'all, like real deal, doing it all. I got the freaking journal entries to prove it, man. It was something that his friend said in chapter 8 that stuck out to me. He said, if you would diligently seek God and implore the compassion and favor of the Almighty. So his friend was telling him to beg for compassion, to beg for favor. So this scripture stuck out to me because he was urging Job to seek God for something he did not have within him, which is compassion and the favor of God. And I'll explain that. Because he didn't believe it, therefore he could not see it. So a lot of the times we will be in places where we have to seek God for something that we don't have within. So if you're having a problem finding peace, because a lot of things can be distractions. So when God takes something away from you, that was a distraction. That was simply a distraction, but it was only a temporary distraction. So if you find joy in these things, and these things can make you happy, but if these are your source, if you want to feel this specific thing and this is your source for that thing, and it gets taken away, you no longer have that within you, and you can no longer turn to that thing. You understand? So his friend was telling him to beg God, to seek God for what he did not have within himself. Job did not have compassion within himself, because before I did this Bible study, I did a Bible study on Job 6 and 7, I believe. And it was Job's friend and then Job's response, I believe. And Jehovah pointed out to me that his friend reprimanded him. Like, he did not give him comfort. He didn't help him out. Like, he was just necessarily directing him back to God, but not in a loving, kind of way. Like, he was speaking to him as though he's done something wrong. And a lot of times we speak to ourselves like that. Like, we are not our friend, but we are our worst enemy. So it's like, how we speak to ourselves, like our perspective of ourselves, really matter. Because a lot of the time we don't understand the truth and who we are to God, and whose we are in general, and who we are in Christ. Okay, so that stuck out to me because, like I said, he was telling Job to seek God for the things that he did not have in him. So in all these seasons, the things that are taken away from you, whether it be suddenly over a span of time, we have to learn to, yes, acknowledge what we feel, acknowledge our hurt, acknowledge our pain, acknowledge our despair, but we also cannot allow ourselves to wallow in it for long, okay? Because we are human. We feel our emotions. Because one thing about me, I'll feel it, but it is God who calls me. He calls me when I'm feeling these things, and he urges me to speak to him about them. What you lack within can only be fulfilled through God. And you're not going to be able to understand that and fully see that and fully have that perspective unless you are in that situation. Like, a lot of, you live and you learn. How about that? You live and you learn. In order to learn these things, I can't just tell you these things. You have to experience these things and know exactly what I'm talking about. But if you're listening to this, you'll know if this is for you or not, okay? Sometimes we confuse humility and submission, and we need to separate one from the other in order to see the direct correlation between our actions and our thoughts. So God was bringing it to my attention that humility and submission are two different things. And I know I've done this in the past where I saw them as one, and yes, they do connect, but they are, in the end, two separate meanings, okay? So let me read y'all the definition. Humility is a modest or low view of one's own importance. And then submission is the action or fact of accepting or yielding to a superior force or to the will or authority of another person. So humility deals with your perspective, your view, okay? And submission deals with your heart posture and your willingness. Because you can view yourself as below God, of course. You're saying, I know these things. Like, I know that God deserves all the glory, all the honor. I'm not in control of the situation. All these things like that. But are you submitting your emotions, your feelings, what is on your heart to God? And are you willing to allow God to shift your perspective from one way to another? Because a lot of us, we want to present ourselves as humble before God. And I always pray that God places me in the position to be humble. Not that he humbles me, but he places me in the position to be humble, because I want to know, have good judgment on humility, okay? Like, when to be humble, when to do these things, that, this, that, and the third, okay? We all have that, okay, Lord, I want to be humble before you, and then other times, I can say from experience, you just blatantly just do what you want to do. But God is good, okay? God forgives. God is merciful. God is faithful. But we have to learn how to shift, like I said, actions and thoughts correlated to humility and submission. We have to learn to allow God to shift our perspective. And through that, we have to place our emotions to the side and essentially open the door for change, open the door for more of God. So me seeking the Lord during Bible study, actually wanting to read the word and hear his voice, I have to change the way I study the word. I have to change the way I pray. I have to change the way I seek God. I have to change the way I speak to God. I have to change the way I view God. And the only way to do that is to allow God into that. And to go into specifics about that is a whole thing in itself, because everybody's relationship with God is unique. But when you open that door to God and you pray and you humble yourself before him and you actually allow him into your heart and into your mind, and you pray that he gifts you with a renewed heart and mind, and you're actually aware, constantly making yourself aware of his presence, aware of his goodness, aware of the season he has you in, aware of your thoughts, aware of your actions and your choices. And this happens over a course of time, but with that willingness, with that submission, you're able to fully see what God is trying to get you to see. You're able to see where God is taking you. And in a lot of seasons, like how Job was, confused. He was confused. He wasn't understanding, like, what did I do wrong? We're not perfect. None of us deserve what God gives us, okay? None of us deserve these things that God gives us, but the favor of God is on our lives and he loves us. So don't you want to continuously open your mind and your heart to the Spirit of God to allow that change and that fresh perspective and that compass within you to direct your steps? We have to learn how to open our eyes to the fact that God is truly bigger than us, and what we're dealing with is truly bigger than us, and who God brings into our lives is truly bigger than us. Because I know me, for example, I can allow my emotions to dictate certain actions and choices that I make, but I will learn to humble myself before God, understand that my perspective may not be the perspective that God has because of my flesh, my emotions, what I'm feeling, okay? The trauma, the things from the past, okay? But when I go to God and I speak to him and I communicate with him and I submit these thoughts and these emotions and these feelings to him, only then will that door be opened for God to truly do his works within me. So I'm in this season of reinventing myself, and I'm not saying, oh, like, I just want to do a whole 180 with my life. That's not what I want to do. My definition in this season of my life is changing two habits. It's two habits I'm working on. I'm shifting my perspective, okay? And I'm trying to allow myself to move more slowly and with the flow of the Holy Spirit. I'm trying not to get caught up in hustle culture. I'm trying not to allow anxiety to take away the beauty in the season and the place and the position that God has me in. So my definition of reinventing myself is, how do I want to carry myself? What does consistency look like to me? To me, consistency in my life right now is being consistent with my word. Not the word of God, but my word, the things I say. Being consistent with my word, and also being consistent with opening the door to God. Because a lot of the times I can get so caught up in, okay, I'm doing this for the Lord, I'm doing this for the Lord, I'm doing this for the Lord. But at the end of the day, Jehovah has emotions too. Jehovah has feelings too. Jehovah has wants too. Jehovah has desires for me as well. So I want to learn how to open the door to the desires that he has for me. Like, God, give me the desires you have for me. Burden me with who I am supposed to be in this season. You know, I'm ranting, but y'all, like, this is really my perspective. This is really like my video diary, like my vlog. Like, these are the things that I think about on a daily basis. These are the things that I try to incorporate on a daily basis, because I can't get caught up in what other people are doing. I can't even get caught up in what I think I should be doing, because it's all about balance. It's all about not killing yourself to get to where you think that God wants you to be. You only know the version of yourself that God has shown you. God can take you way further, way higher than you can even imagine. He could take me way further, higher than I can even imagine. And I may not completely understand the full circle moment of why I'm in this season, or what specifically he wants me to do in this season, but I'm trying my best and I'm seeking him. I'm opening the doors to him, and I'm trying my best to not be perfect, but I'm trying my best to be willing, to be submitted, and to be humble. So that was the purpose of this Bible study, you guys. I wanted to tell you guys about it because I just wanted to open my mind up to you guys more. I feel like in my vlogs I'm always on the go or something like that, and I never really allow myself to sit and talk to you all. That's a big bug. I never really sit and allow myself to talk to you all. So yeah, we're gonna go get matcha, and then we're gonna end this vlog, because I really hope this helped somebody out there listening, because I really just want you to know that you're doing your best, and that's all that matters. Nothing is ever going to be perfect. I'm trying to get my head out of that. Nothing is ever going to be perfect. Even when I feel like I'm at the place where this is what I prayed for, this, that, and the third, nothing is going to be perfect, because if there were perfection, we wouldn't need God. There always has to be imperfections within our lives, within our minds, within our hearts. Not to be impure, but to be in a space where we have to open the door to God. My camera's really on 12%. But I hope you guys enjoyed a day with me. It's currently 2:55. And I'm going to finish up the thumbnail, description, and timestamps. And also links as well for my video before this, which is my Shein haul. And this is Miss Girl. I don't know if the light is doing her justice. There we go. This is Miss Girl. This matcha. So I believe it's just matcha with like carrot cake, cream foam, sweet foam. I don't know. But either way, it's really good. And thank you guys for watching today's video. I pray that this video blessed you in a... Dang, they just freaked up that parking. I pray that this video blessed you and it helped you get an understanding that you can start now. You have the power of change and God is on your side. It's time to reinvent ourselves. Not from the outside, but the inside. Jesus' name.